Now recognize the gentleman from New York, Mr. Morelle, for 5 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I do note, since there seems to be a fair amount of conversation and speculation about what happened in the conversations between Mr. Irving and Speaker Pelosi, why Mr. Irving wasn't asked to testify in front of this panel. You could have asked him to come. I assume that you chose not to, because it's easier to speculate on the conversations rather than ask him to testify, and I assume he would have been here to testify, but in any case. Since there seems to be a real focus on the 1 hour that there's a dispute over whether or not authorization was given, I am a little surprised that there's no frustration or concern about the 3.5 hours between the time you did place the call, and I did understand, sir, you placed the call at 2:30, according to your testimony here, to requesting National Guard support?
No, so to correct it, I couldn't wait any longer. I had waited so long for the approval from the Capitol Police Board, both Mr. Irving and Mr. Stinger. At 1:51 p.m., I called William Walker without even having authority and said, please get ready, send me anything you got.
Gotcha.
This is life or death. I told him I don't have approval from the Capitol Police Board yet, but it's coming any minute, but please start sending me resources.
Gotcha.
So it was 1:51
when I first
made that call.
That was before 2 o'clock, and yet, so, and when did the National Guard show up?
5:40 p.m., the first National Guard showed up, approximately 150, and they were sworn in as special police officers and deployed. They got on post about 6 p.m. When the Capitol grounds were secure at that point.
Okay, so that is over 3.5 hours after your request was put in.
Yes, sir.
Earlier I was asking about this, and I would like to just get a little more a definition on it. So you didn't know it at the time. When you made the request at 1:50 or so, did you know that, when were you made aware that there were restrictions on what the National Guard could do as a result of the memo that had been issued on the 4th and 5th?
I don't know the exact date, but it was definitely after January 6th when I started doing research into what happened. That's when I found it.
But when they showed up at 5:40, so do you have any sense of the 3.5 hours that went on? You said, I just want to make sure, you said in an interview that there was a concern in the administration about the president invoking the Insurrection Act and concern at the Pentagon about him declaring martial law or activating the military in support of his claims. Do you suspect that played a role in the Pentagon's unwillingness to allow the National Guard to respond to the Capitol, that those hours that was being debated?
So when I went back and started doing research for the book I wrote, I started finding out there was a lot of concerns within the president's cabinet about him invoking the Insurrection Act, and that was one of the hypotheses that had come up, that maybe they were concerned about him invoking it, and that's why they'd want to delay. And think about it. I think Secretary of Defense has come out and stated in testimony he was not putting National Guard anywhere east of 9th Street Northwest, which means toward the Capitol. So why would that be?
I don't know. Why do you speculate?
I am saying, for some reason, they want to do everything they could to keep National Guard away from the Capitol.
Yeah. I would wonder why my colleagues aren't more concerned about that. I mean, that's 3.5 hours while we're under siege. Request has been made. Can you describe the scene during the period between your call and the arrival of the National Guard here at the Capitol?
Between my first call at 12:58.
Your call at 2 o'clock, until 5:40?
It was, I was seeing my officers go through some intensive battling on the West Front. It was terrible what they were going through, and no police officer deserves to be subjected to that. It was some of the worst violence I've seen against police law enforcement.
So let me ask this then, how would the situation have differed had the National Guard's quick reaction force been able to deploy soon after your call, which I assume would have been just minutes away?
Yeah, if they had followed their emergency authority and they had deployed the quick QRF, we could have had close to 200 National Guardsmen, men or women here fairly quickly. That could have been a game changer. The Metropolitan Police Department sent me almost 1,000 officers. That would have been the next largest cadre of officers. We could have absolutely used their assistance.
Yeah. You know, I am on a sort of tragic circumstance. You obviously know about then Police Lieutenant Michael Byrd and the interaction, which ultimately led to the death of Ashli Babbitt. It was a rioter when she tried to break into the Speaker's lobby. Because of his actions, now Captain Byrd and his family have had to face an onslaught of threats and been the target of vile attacks, some of them racist. Just a few weeks ago, a family member of Ms. Babbitt said publicly that Michael Byrd needs to swing from the end of a rope. Do you have any reaction to that comment?
No comment on that.
No comment. Yield back, may I ask unanimous consent to enter into the record the following. An article from the Washington Post fact checker dated December 15, 2021, entitled, No, Trump did not order 10,000 troops to secure the Capitol on January 6th. An article from CNN entitled, Fact Checking Representative Jordan's Claim That Speaker Pelosi Was Responsible for U.S. Capitol Security on January 6th. A memorandum from the Secretary of Defense to the Secretary of the Army dated January 4th, 2021, restricting the activities of the D.C. National Guard. A letter from the Secretary of the Army to the Commanding General of the D.C. National Guard dated January 5th, relaying those National Guard restrictions. An excerpt from the Select Committee's transcribed interview with former House Sergeant-at-Arms Paul Irving. A copy of HCON Res 40, a concurrent resolution expressing support for law enforcement officers that explicitly excluded the United States Capitol Police. A copy of an amendment to HCON Res 40 offered in the Rules Committee by Ranking Member McGovern expressing gratitude to the Capitol Police who protected the Capitol on January 6th. A copy of the vote tally and the amendment, which was defeated on a party line 8-3 vote, all Republicans voting against. A tweet by Representative Matt Gaetz dated September 14, 2023, in which he pledges to hold Speaker McCarthy to his promise to release the full January 6th tapes. Tweet by Representative Matt Gaetz dated September 18th, 2023, in which he demands full release of the January 6th tapes in exchange for funding the government. And finally, a letter from Capitol Police Chief Tom Manger to Chairman Stile and myself dated September 18th, 2023, in which he renews his request to review all video footage requests received by the committee and address security concerns prior to release. Without objection.
Without objection. Now recognized.